This is The Art of Breathing by Danny Penman. Chapter 5, Curiosity. It's impossible to be unhappy and curious at the same time. But habits kill curiosity. And around half of your life is ruled by habit. They may streamline your life and free up time and energy for you to do more useful and interesting things. But they can also become a trap, quite a vicious one. Habits begin wearing grooves in the mind and become hardwired into your brain. One habit triggers the next and the next, so that whole chunks of your life are run on autopilot. Unless you're careful, they'll control almost every aspect of your life, including your taste in food, clothes, music, and even your choice of partner. Habits govern how you interact with everyone around you, how you solve problems, how you conjure up new ideas, and your entire approach to the world. As Aristotle once said, we are what we repeatedly do. Habits can enhance limitations and trap you in negative states of mind. And the more often you criticize yourself, the easier it is to slip into the same habit the next time, and the next, and the next. What's up with me today? Why do I keep doing stupid things like this? Why can't I just do it? My life's a bit of a mess. I'm exhausted. One thought triggers the next, in an endless downward spiral. It's the sound of your inner critic, and it's always with you. Your inner critic is the voice of the negativity bias, and you're ushering it along by habit. But habits aren't destiny, unless you allow them to be. In fact, you can breathe them away. Habits arise when your mind is elsewhere. They dissolve when you mindfully bring your focus back to the present moment. Observe your habits often enough, and their underlying neutral patterns will wither away and leave behind a calmer, clearer, more insightful mind. So when you realize you've been snared by an unwanted habit, or feel trapped by your inner critic, or suffer from anxious, stressful, bleak, or otherwise negative thoughts, do something they'll really hate. Take a few gentle, deep breaths. Feel the ground beneath your feet. Breathing space meditation. Take a breathing space. Adopt your usual meditation posture, or stand if you prefer. Gently close your eyes. Step one, arriving. Begin by noticing whatever is going on around you. Become aware of the space around you. Feel the ground beneath your feet. What's going on in your mind and body right now? Briefly scan through your body and tune in to the most noticeable sensations. Don't try to change anything. Simply feel the sensations. Begin paying attention to the emotions flowing through your mind and body. Don't try to change anything. Pay attention to their intensity and notice how they rise and fall. What thoughts are around? Don't try to change anything. Simply observe them. Remember that thoughts are not facts. Step 2. Focusing. Shift your awareness to your breath. Follow it all the way in and all the way out for 30 seconds or so. Each time your mind wanders, gently escort your awareness back to your breath. Step 3. Expanding. Begin to broaden your awareness to include your whole body. Feel your whole body breathing for 30 seconds or so. If there are any areas of tension or discomfort, imagine breathing into them with a sense of warmth and kindness. Then begin to progressively broaden your awareness to encompass the space around you. Gently open your eyes. Curiosity kills habits. Things to break and do. Habits are the mind's sheepdogs. Set yourself free by unleashing your curiosity. Do as many of the following as you wish. Whatever you do, do it consciously, with full awareness. Be curious. Be energetic. Be alive. Spend 30 minutes less at work. Sit at a different table or chair. Pick up a new book to get lost in. Stop every 2 hours and consciously breathe. Eat something you've never eaten before. Switch supermarkets. Watch the sky for half an hour. Take a different commute to work. Go to the seaside, the countryside, the mountains, or even the local park.